It's the most wonderful time. It's the most wonderful time. It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Good morning, everyone. It is Vlogmas day 3, and you might be wondering why I'm starting Vlogmas this early today, but it is about 8 a.m. I have class. I have lab at 8:30 and class at 11, and today's Vlogmas is going to be a what I eat in a day vlog style, kind of. I'm going to do like a little bit of cooking later. Gonna go out to eat too, like get some sushi. So I'm going to put all of that in this vlog. And so, like I said, it is 8 a.m. I have my first class at 8:30, and I'm gonna take you guys downstairs and show you guys what I eat for breakfast pretty much every day. I meal prep these. They are overnight oats, and so I meal prep like on Sunday night. I'll meal prep like 5 of them, or however many I think that I'm gonna need, and they will be what I eat the entire week. So I'm gonna take you guys downstairs and show you guys that, and yeah, I'm excited for this vlog today. I'm not gonna be vlogging like the whole day. I'm just gonna kind of be doing like when I'm about to eat, so it's the good stuff for the vlog. But yeah, a lot of people ask me still, like, I've done like what I eat in the day, but I haven't done one in a while, and so I thought I would do one like right now. Just because my diet seems to change all the time. And so, like, the main thing that I've been doing now, like I said, is overnight oats. And I've also been loving this chicken dish that I'm going to share with you later. Me and Reggie make it all the time. I'm just going to share with you guys, not the exact way that we make it, because I make it different whenever he's here, because he eats a lot more food than me. And so I'm going to show you a, like, similar way that I make it, and it still tastes just as good. And then I'm going to get some sushi later with some of my friends. And then I go to work tonight from like 6 to midnight, and I usually end up getting Starbucks or like a snack, so I'll put that in there too for you guys. But yeah, I'm excited for this video, so let's go look at breakfast. Also, I wanted to add into this vlog, I have been taking care of vitamins now for about a year, and I live by them. And so if I have a code, I'll put it right here. I don't know if I do or not. I always, like, sometimes, like, just having an account on a website gives you a code. So when I say, like, oh, use my code, I'm not sponsored. It's usually just they give a majority of people that have an account a code in order to, like, share it. And so if I have a code, I will put it down below. But they are vitamins. They are completely designed for you. So you get on careof.com, you take a quiz, you put about like where you live. I've talked about these before, but you put like where you live, I'm sure you've heard of them, your diet, your lifestyle, stuff like that, and they customize you a pack of vitamins. So you take the same vitamins every day. And yeah, this one, each of them say something. This one just says, hi Megan, hey, how are you, just checking in, if you need anything, email or text. And it just has their email and their text mess, their phone number. So I just take one of these a day. I take 6. I'm not exactly sure now like what they are. No, 2 calcium pills. I'm honestly not sure. I recently like retook my test not that long ago, actually. It was probably like a month or two ago, and I retook my test, and it like told me the exact same thing. So I didn't add anything or any of that. But yeah, this is how I start my day though, and this is just water. It's not coffee today, it's just water. So I'm just gonna take my vitamins. Okay, so these are the overnight oats, and I just put styrofoam, or aluminum foil over them. They're in there like that. And then when I get ready to go, I just throw in blueberries and a little bit of honey on them. I don't put the fruit in like overnight because I just don't want it to get soggy. So yeah, this is my little like to-go breakfast, and It's so yummy and so good. I'll share with you guys how I make it later on today, because I need to get out the door. So I will see you guys when I'm making lunch. Hey guys, so I just finished up in class, and so now I'm at the gym. So I went to my two classes. I stopped and got Dunkin' in between those classes. So I put that in, so I get a caramel cold brew with almond milk every day, pretty much. Unless I make coffee by myself at home, which I do something very similar. I use like cold brew coffee and then use a caramel almond milk creamer. And so now I'm at the gym. I'm just doing like some cardio and abs today, but sometimes I'll eat before the gym. Like today, if it was a leg day, I probably would have ate something, but since I'm doing cardio, I don't like to have a lot of food in my stomach beforehand. So I like wonder if anyone can hear me. So I'm gonna go run on the treadmill, do a little bit of an ab circuit. I was supposed to have an intramural basketball game tonight, but we're gonna have to forfeit. We don't have enough players. So this is gonna be like my cardio. And yeah, so I haven't really ate anything new, but just kind of like updating you guys. Also, I've drank this entire thing of water once already. So I'm drinking it again, like at the gym. I usually finish it. It is 30 ounces of water. So like, that's pretty good to drink. For Christmas, I'm getting a hydro jug, which is like a gallon, and you're supposed to drink like that, like one time through throughout the day. So I'm pretty sure two of these would be one hydro jug. I don't know, I can't do the math in my head right now, but I've been getting used to drinking a lot of water throughout the day, especially whenever you have coffee and you're active and stuff. You should try to, like, for as much coffee you drink like two times that amount in water. Also, a little like side note on cardio days, I eat almost in a caloric deficit. Pretty much I eat about 2,000 calories on a cardio day, but on a leg day or on like a mass, like muscle mass day, I'll eat like over 2,000 calories. Okay guys, so I'm home from the gym. As you can see, I'm pretty red from doing cardio today, but I just wanted to share with you guys, like, I guess supplements, I would call them, that I use for the gym. On leg days, I take protein. On cardio and ab days, I usually don't, unless like I notice that I'm low in protein those days. Oh, this one's broken. But I've been using these little protein packets. They're just by the Body Fortress protein packs. They're just whey protein in, is it whey protein? Yeah, 100% premium whey protein, 40 grams of protein in each thing. So also on leg days, I take, not necessarily like a pre-workout, but I do have a Spark right before that. So this is Advocare Spark. It is just an energy, vitamin, and amino acid supplement that sharpens mental focus, gives you long-lasting energy, and it's sugar-free. So I'll have this, with one scoop of that mixed with one scoop of the Mass Impact. This is a multi-nutrient amino acid supplement. It enhances your workouts by providing nutrients to supplement or to support muscle building. It also contains ingredients to support rehydration and muscle recovery. This is what I use on leg day, a scoop of each of these. And then on my cardio and ab days, I use the Rehydrate, which is an electrolyte drink. So obviously it supplies your body back with electrolytes. So this is a lot better for you than drinking like Gatorade or like a full of sugar drink. And so since today I did cardio, I'm just going to throw a scoop of this into my water bottle and have some Rehydrate. I'm gonna go shower, and then when I'm done in the shower, I'm gonna come downstairs and cook lunch slash dinner. I'm gonna make enough to take a little bit to work with me tonight. I work 6 to midnight this evening, but I'm also going to get sushi around 4:30-ish. I'm only gonna be getting sushi. I'm not gonna be like eating a meal, so obviously that's not gonna hold me over all night. So I'm just gonna make a little bit of extra for what I make for dinner and then just take the same thing with me to work. Hey guys, so it is now like 2 o'clock, and so I'm just gonna make some dinner. Like I said earlier, I'm going to be making some dinner, I guess lunch, I guess it's not dinner, but I'm gonna be making some to eat now and then take the extra for dinner tonight when I go to work, because I am going to get sushi here in a little bit. And so this dinner is going to be some chicken breasts, some sweet peppers, and then I have spring mix. Tonight I'm gonna make it as a salad, just because how I said earlier about on cardio days I eat like less calories. And so if it were a leg day, or like when Reggie's here, we make it with pasta and not salad, or we'll have like a salad on the side. But I'm gonna skip the carbs today, and I'm just going to go with putting it into a spring mix with some dressing. So what I do is I take the peppers, as many peppers as I want to make, and I cut them up on a cutting board with a knife first, and then I use a separate cutting board, and I use the same knife though, but I use a separate cutting board and cut up the chicken on this cutting board using the same knife. Obviously you don't want to cut up the chicken first and then the peppers, because you can get like cross-contamination and stuff like that from the chicken, raw chicken. And then I put it all in a pan with some olive oil, and I let the chicken get like a good white color, add seasoning to it, and then the peppers don't have to cook that much, like as long as the chicken. So about halfway through, I'll add the peppers in, I'll add some seasoning, and then I add a little bit of water to it just to keep the moisture there. And then afterwards, like I said, I'm just gonna put it on some spring mix. And then tonight for work, I'm just gonna pack up the extra stuff and take it with me. Usually I just like make one chicken breast. If Reggie's here, we'll get like bigger chicken breasts, and we'll make like 1.5. He obviously eats more than me. So depending on how big these chicken breasts are, I might make one or like 2, maybe 1.5. I'm gonna see, but I will show you guys the process as I'm going along. Okay, so I used about 1.5 thinly sliced chicken breasts. They're in there in some olive oil. I have my peppers all cut up, and these are just gonna sizzle for a little bit, and then I'm going to put the peppers in and then add the seasoning. Okay, so now the peppers are going in. As you can see, there's like a little bit of marks on the bottom of the pan, just from the chicken beginning to stick to the bottom. We don't have the best pan in the world for cooking right now, but we're college kids on a budget. But this is what it looks like now. I'm gonna add a little bit of water and then some seasoning. And for the last 5 minutes or so, I just cover it so it keeps that moisture in there and it can kind of almost like steam. So by doing that, you can kind of like steam or saute the chicken, and it keeps it like moisture the whole way throughout the chicken without drying it out. I've noticed like when I leave it uncovered, sometimes like the water just sits there and then it doesn't like keep the moisture. I hate dry chicken, and I refuse to make dry chicken in my life. So this is the best way that I've found that keeps the chicken nice and moist. I hate that word. So when I eat salads, I usually use a pretty big bowl. So I'm just using like a bowl like this big, and I'm just gonna load it up with some spring mix. So I put like 2 handfuls in, and honestly, it barely even made a dent in this, but it's stuffed pretty full with good greens, and this is what the chicken and peppers are looking like. You can see they're starting to pick up some of the seasoning as the water is steaming them, basically. For dressing, I think I'm going to use some of this Simply Nature Organic Chipotle Ranch dressing. I think this will be good with it. Chicken and peppers and stuff. It's like a chipotle, spicy, a little bit ranch. So I'm going to put a little bit, I really like dressing, and so I'm going to put a little bit on now so it's like touching the leaves. And then when I put the chicken and stuff on, I'll add more dressing to the top of it because that's just, I like dressing. Okay guys, so I'm done cooking it. I'm going to show you guys here what it looks like. Just trying to find good lighting, you know? But, got the chicken, the peppers, put the chipotle ranch on it, and it looks so, so good. I can't wait to eat it. So this is what it looks like. Okay, so I'm about to head and go get sushi, and then I'm gonna be going to work. So I'm gonna close out the vlog here. I will put in, obviously, me eating my sushi right here for you guys. Go ahead. Go dig in.
Use your knife and your fork.
Let me see. Should I got something fancy?
No, show them your basic.
My basic ass shrimp. Spicy shrimp and spicy crab. And then when I get to work, if I do get Starbucks, I'm going to be editing the rest of this video at work. So if I do get Starbucks, I'll put it in here. I feel like I might not get Starbucks though. But if I do, I usually get a matcha green tea latte with almond milk. And so, like I said, if I get it, I will put it in. And other than that, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please remember to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you can see the rest of my Vlogmas videos. Because there are 10 more coming your way, and the next few are going to be exciting, and I am ready to get them uploaded for you guys. So I'll see you guys all in my next video. Peace.